Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm going to be taking you guys on a step-by-step process as well as the different materials and tools which you need to achieve a DIY drawstring ponytail by yourself at home. So if you're interested, then you want to keep on watching. Okay, so the first thing which you're going to be needing is you're actually going to need a dummy head to act as, you know, the canvas for which you're going to sew the ponytail onto. You're going to need this net. It's a drawstring ponytail net. Also going to be needing some T-pins which you use to pin the net to the dummy head. Okay, so you're also going to be needing some thread as well as some needles, right? Or just one needle actually. So you're going to be needing one needle. It's the normal sewing needle which you use in sewing clothes, hand sewing needle, and this is what it looks like, right? So these are the things which you're going to be needing for this tutorial in order to create a ponytail, a DIY ponytail for yourself. So what I'm doing right now is to just basically pass this thread through the eye of the needle, right? This is a normal thing you do when you're using a sewing needle or a hand sewing needle, right? So what I'm doing now is trying to create a very large knot because the needle is a very big needle, so you need a large knot just so that it's not loose at the end. So try to create a large knot. You can see how large this knot is. There's no way it's going to lose, right? So next thing you want to do is to actually use the T-pins, right, and just pin the net, the ponytail net, onto the dummy head. That way you're able to, you know, have a very firm canvas to work on. So I'm pinning this on four sides, on the four different sides, just so that we have it firm and stable, and then we can start sewing the extensions onto the net. Okay, so this is what it's looking like right now. Now these are the extensions which I'm going to be using. It is what I use in all of my, you know, most of my ponytail videos. Okay, so this is what it looks like. It is fluffy, it is soft, it comes in like three bundles, making it very full and voluminous. So yeah, this is what it looks like. And now what I'm trying to do is just to detangle this because I'm opening up the wefts just so that we can start sewing this onto the dummy head, okay, onto the net rather. So now this is what it's looking like. I'm going to try to, you know, take it around and see how far it goes, and also notice that I'm not going to be cutting this extensions, right? So now what I'm doing is I'm grabbing some other T-pins and I'm just using those T-pins to clip the extensions onto the net first of all before we start sewing, just so that we have it, you know, secured, right? And then I'm going to do this all the way around to see how far this goes. Okay, so I'm taking more T-pins, attach this to the dummy head. Okay, so now we are going to go right into sewing this. Remember the needle and thread which we have, and just start sewing the wefts of this ponytail onto the net. Okay, it's a normal way you would sew your clothes or anything. However, I made sure that I was sewing directly onto the wefts. I don't know how to explain it to you guys, but I would take a closer view and show you guys. You can see I am trying to put the needle through the wefts. Okay, so you know the part where it is sewn, and that is like the beginning of the extensions, that is where I am attaching my needle to, okay, so that it is firm and it's very secured. So I'm sewing this round the whole ponytail net. Okay, so this just makes it, that is what makes it a ponytail. Instead of you know, sewing from side to side, you first of all sew it round the edges of the ponytail net, and then you can then go into sewing it side to side, okay, to cover in the spaces in between. So that is what I'm doing, and I'm just going to do this all the way through to make sure that this is secured, right? So I want you guys to take note of how I'm actually threading this ponytail, right? So once you pass your needle through the extensions and through the nets, right, before you just make everything into like a knot, cross the needle over the thread to make a loop. Okay, so I'm going to it's more explanation when you watch it than me trying to explain, because it's quite difficult to explain, but basically try to create a loop Don't just pass the needle and that's it. Create a loop, and that way it is more secured. You're sure that it's not going to loosen. If you just go straight into passing the needle through and then just, you know, coming back out, it's not going to be firm. It's not going to be tight enough to hold it together. So try as much as possible to do that to make sure it is more secured. I'd like you to know that I wouldn't advise anyone to cut their extensions. Why? Because you might want to use this as maybe another wig. You might want to repurpose this to get another wig. So it wouldn't be advisable to keep on cutting your extension. So what I would advise is whenever you get to the end of the net, just flip your extensions over and then just keep on sewing. Try as much as possible, avoid the temptation to cut your extensions. Okay, so just flip it over and just keep on sewing. When you get to the next end, flip it over again and then just keep on sewing, right? So what I'm doing now is just basically trying to create a knot, because this particular extension is done. We're going to get another bundle and then just keep on sewing to that. So what I'm doing is trying to create a knot, that way it is secured, and then I'm going to cut that using a scissors, right? So this is what we're looking like currently. You can also see how I flipped the extensions over instead of cutting the extensions to, you know, keep going forward. Okay, so here we have a closer view on how I'm actually making sure that the needle passes through each of the wefts. As you can see, make sure that it passes through each of the wefts. You're not missing out anyone, that way it doesn't loosen. So do all you can to make sure that this comes out the best. Feel free to use the ponytail combs, which people usually attach, but I feel like it is not a necessity. It is not it's not compulsory, in quotes, to use that ponytail comb. Okay, as far as you have your bun and your string, right, you can just place this and draw the string, use your extensions, and make sure it is secure at the back. You can decide to use the ponytail comb. All you need to do is just to sew it onto the edges of the ponytail net. That just acts as the ponytail comb, which helps it to be more secure. But like I said, it is not compulsory, right? So now I'm done sewing the extensions and I'm just trying to create a knot to make sure that it doesn't loosen up from where we stopped. Okay, and then I'm going to cut that with the scissors, and this is what it's looking like right now. So you remember how we sewed everything from the top round the extensions, round the edges of the ponytail net. Now when you bring that part of the extension backwards, you can see that you have your ponytail. Okay, so you can see how neat the edges are, and this is what the extensions basically look like. So it is fluffy, it is secured, it's not going to loosen, and this is what we have. You can see how fluffy and bouncy it is. And now I'm just going to remove the T-pins just to show you guys the finished result. So this is what the inside of the ponytail looks like, and you can see it is neat and everything looks well sewn, right? So now for you to get the ponytail out of this, that is why it is a drawstring ponytail. All you need to do is just draw the string and there you have it, your ponytail. So what you can do now is to attach this onto your little bun at the back of your hair. Here are the videos where I have used these extensions, right? If you haven't checked them out, feel free to check them out right here on my channel, where you see how these extensions are used. So don't forget to like, share, comment, and subscribe. And I'll see you guys in my next video.